gave me a letter and said, Geeta, I'm going to write 5 girls' names and 5 boys' names in this letter. If you get an opportunity, can you please give my letter to Swami? Usually, I'm a little bit hesitant to take letters because once I took a lot of letters to Swami, and Swami was not very pleased. He said, when did you become Prashanthi Nilayam postman? I started to deliver everybody's letters to me. So I was not sure whether it was a good idea. So I said, I will take it. But if Swami asks for it, I will give it. Otherwise, I will keep it. I hope you don't. She said, no, no. If you want, I can mail it. She said, no, no. If he asks and takes it from you, you give it otherwise. But she didn't seal the envelope. And I told her, look, you have not sealed the envelope. She said, no, no. In case Swami looks, you know, like any mother who wants the blessings for her child, this is the most natural thing for any parent. So she said, you know, I don't want to seal it. In case Swami looks at it, in case he chooses her name, so I will not seal it. You give it. I said, oh my goodness, you know, she's having all these ideas in her head. What will I do? She'll be disappointed. You know, when our desires don't get fulfilled, we feel disappointed. I said, I'll take it. And I gave her very sort of low expectation. I said, I'll keep it with me. If you ask me only, I'll give. I don't know if Swami will see all those things. I told him. I arrived in Prashanthi Nilayam. That day itself, Swami called me. I didn't have the letter with me because Swami had already come out when we went to Prashanthi Nilayam. So we just left all our suitcase in the car and just ran for darshan. As soon as I entered, Swami was coming. He said, go inside. So I didn't have the letter with me. I went into the interview room and Swami gave her. And we finished all that and we came out. And when I came back to the room, I told my mother, you know, I forgot Ramya's letter. You know, so my mother said, tomorrow morning you keep it for darshan time. Swami takes it. So I kept it and I'm afraid to keep it in my hand because he has already called me postman. So with my pallu, I covered it with my sari and I sat. If he wants it, he will ask it. I'm not going to. So he came and he talked to some few people and called few people for the interview. Finished their interview and he came out again and came near me and said, you go for it. Second time, the following day. So, okay, I went inside. I didn't think about the letter. My mother and I went inside and we sat down. And Swami said, what news? No news. Yesterday itself, we have told all the news. And I said, oh, but we are very happy that Swami has called me second time. We were chatting. Then few minutes he talked and then he hit me on my cheek and said, when are you going to give me your friend's letter? Is a lady, is a doctor, she has never talked to Swami or had an interview or any such physical. I said, oh Swami, I forgot Swami, here it is. So it was not sealed as I said. He took out, opened the letter, looked at it, looked at everything. He didn't say anything. He put the letter back in the envelope, closed the flap and gave it back and give it back to her, he said. So I said, okay, maybe, you know, he wants her to keep it as a memory that he has looked at it. So I took the letter, we finished the interview, Swami gave some vibhuti, we came out of the interview room. And I'm sitting, then the bhajan started, I'm sitting in the darshan and I was just turning the letter over and suddenly I realized that the letter is sealed now. Swami did nothing, he just looked at the letter, put it back and just closed the flap like that and gave it to me, but the letter was closed. So I whispered to my mommy, the letter is closed now. So my mother said, keep it. So as soon as the bhajan was over, I went to that STD booth, you know, at that time no cell phone. So I called her and I said, hey, Ramya, Swami too. She was so thrilled that Swami had taken her letter. So I said, he has taken, but the funny thing is he gave the letter back, but it's sealed now. So I had just arrived in India. I was going to be there for 4 weeks. So shall I courier it to you? I asked her because she may have the baby, you know. I thought maybe she'll want it. So she said, no, the letter will get lost. Swami has touched it. I'll keep it in my altar just because he has touched it, you know. So I'll keep it in my altar. You bring it and give it to me whenever you come because it might get lost. Plus, I don't want everybody touching it and it will lose its power. You know, she had her own in her head. I said, okay. I kept it and stayed in Bangalore and went back to Washington. And when I went, as soon as we arrived, my husband died the following week. Thursday, bhajan, she invited us. We went to their house. And I gave her the letter. Now, the husband and wife are, husband is saying, let's open the letter, open the letter. Saying, no, I wanted to keep it till the baby is born, you know. I don't want. The husband won the argument. He said, I'm opening it. I'm curious. Why did Swami seal it, you know? He could have just given it back. And they opened the letter and took it out. He said, oh, he's given the name, he said. She said, no, don't tell me. I don't want to know what baby I'm going to have. You know? Because by the name, you can find out. Because therefore, He said, no. And in the two listeners, then you see how wonderful. He will answer everybody's prayer however you want it. He didn't underline the name. He underlined two names. One in the boy's side, one in the girl's side. So suspense. He didn't physically underline it. Only Divya Drishti. That is why people are sitting in the darshan line. They came and told me, we were so far away. From far away, Swami looked at us. I said, that divine Drishti has more power than even the word can have. Okay, I tell them this incident. So, boy's name Aniruddha has been underlined. Girl's name Samyukta has been underlined. So one of it. So we don't know whether it's going to be a boy or a girl, right? And then we look, and inside that there is Vibhuti and two gold pendants. One is a Om and one is a Lakshmi. Inside that, all with one look, just one drishti. We put it back. We kept it near the doctor. They were both in tears because they never expected. Who are we? We don't know. We are such ordinary people. Why did Swami do this for us? That's the next question they want. See, even if we get the grace, we want to know why we got the grace. So anyway, that happened. Sure enough, after a few days, she delivered a boy baby named in Aniruddha. And of course, I thought I'm very knowledgeable because I did all these things. This ego will once in a while flare up. So I said, oh, because it's a boy, that Om is for the boy. And that Lakshmi is for you, you know, for the mother. Swami has sent for you. You put it on. So she put it in her Mangal Sutra, in her chain. They put the Om for the boy. They named him Aniruddha. They gave the hospital the name. Everything opened. Finished. After a year and a half, a girl was born. So she had to take out that Lakshmi from her. So these two souls, Swami had already welcomed them into the world much before they came, these two children, and sent the Vibhuti. So she was one of the people who would always ask, Geeta, really, does Swami know that I have gone to Prashanthi Nilayam? Does he know where I am sitting? He talks to you, he tells you everything that you think he answers. Does he know? For her question, and for all the questions that many people may have, this was the answer. I know each and every one of you. So I will finish with this last statement of Swami's. The last few years ago, Swami asked me to go to UK to speak. And I said, Swami, what message should I tell them, Swami, from you? I'm going from here, they know that you have asked me to come. He said, no message. I have said everything that I wanted to say. Now you only have to practice. He said, I have said everything I wanted to say. So still Swami, they'll ask me for some message. So Swami sat for very quietly for a few seconds. And then he said, okay, this message you tell wherever you go, you tell them. He said. So I took out my paper and pencil. You know, some long message Swami is going to give so that I should remember. So he said, wherever you go, you tell every devotee. I know each and every one of them. I am with each and every one of them. I love each and every one of them.